1, 2, 3.
She was elected mayor, as you know, in February of 1979. The official date, I guess, was April. And she was the first woman elected to a major city in our country as mayor. And still today, there is no city in America that has had a woman mayor that has more population than the city of Chicago. And I think that's a very special achievement we're proud of. Taste of Chicago, Navy Pier, the museum campus, all the fests, the gospel fest, the blues fest, many, many things. Mayor Byrne had a passion for people then and now, and always will be. I think it's important to understand that when she graduated from Barrett College, after going to St. Scholastica right here in Chicago, she went to college in Lake Forest and then took some courses at UIC. She understood how important it is that education was a mainstay for all of us, and her commitment to education, very, very important. I've had the honor of knowing her daughter, who's with us today, Kathy, and her grandson, Willie, who got himself elected president of the student council at Francis Parker. So the Byrne genes of winning elections are with us. And I think we should not forget that when she came into politics, inspired by President Kennedy, she came into politics and was served as what's now called the Consumer Department. It was the Department of Weights and Measures. I can never forget Jane Byrne going to some of those stores that weren't weighing things properly. Somebody had the thumb on their scale, and she took them on. She was fearless. And I think it's very, very important that we honor special folks who have come through our state of Illinois, who made a difference and made our state better. And there's a lot of ways to honor people, but I think one of the best ways is in our transportation system that we recite every day when we hear the traffic reports. It's important to hear names that are really immortal names for our state. Jane Addams, the tollway on the way from O'Hare all the way to Rockford. That's where Jane Addams got her start, near Rockford, went to Rockford College, and then served right here, not far from here at Hull House, next door here. And we have not only Jane Addams, but we have Jane Byrne. And so we decided that the Jane Byrne interchange would be the right name for a coming together, a bridge that brought people together that come into the city of Chicago, where she served as our mayor from 1979 to 1983. So when you drive on the Kennedy, when you drive on the Dan Ryan, when you drive on Eisenhower, and also on the Congress Parkway, they all come together at the Jane Byrne interchange. And we're going to name that today. I think it's a very important way of honoring somebody very special who understood how important it was for the city of Chicago, the state of Illinois, to be a welcoming place. Everybody in, nobody left out. The very first person, the first person who was a mayor of Chicago who marched in the gay parade was Jane Byrne. And we thank you very much for that willingness to tell all of us how important it is that everyone should be included. No one should be marginalized. So we are going to unveil this today. I want to give the, I think I have it here, something very important, Mayor, that is a replica of what's going to be on Harrison, Van Buren, let's see, Halstead, and one other street I can't remember, but everywhere people come in to Chicago on this mighty road, this interchange that we are now working on with a four-year project to unsnarl the bottlenecks, to make sure that it is a 21st century road that enhances safety, reduces congestion, reduces emissions. It's a very, very important place in America where people come together, and I can't think of a better place named after a great mayor than the Jane Byrne Interchange. There you go, Mayor.